diseases of betel vine. Now we'll see the list of important diseases in betel vine. So my name is NH Shankar Reddy and I am doing PhD plant pathology in Annamalai University. So these are all the list of important diseases in betel vine. First one is foot rot or leaf rot wilt, which is caused by Phytophthora parasitica var piperina. Sclerotium foot rot and wilt, which is caused by Sclerotium rolfsi. Powdery mildew, which is caused by Oidium piperis. Anthraquinosis, which is caused by Coltotrichum piperis. And bacterial leaf spot, which is caused by Xanthomonas campestris, Pathova, Betlicola. These are all the list of important diseases. Now we will see one by one in detail about. So the first one is foot rot or leaf rot or wilt, which is caused by Phytophthora parasitica var piperina. So on the right side, we can see the symptoms. Initially, so brown to dark brown color dirty lesions can be appears on the foliage. If you see on the foliage, brown to dark brown color lesions can be seen. So the affected veins later turned into yellow in color. We can see here yellow color discoloration of leaves in the veins. So initially brown color lesions appears on the leaves and then converted into yellow color, and on the defoliation of leaves and drooping of leaves also can be seen. So once if it starts to convert into yellow in color, so the affected plants completely dry up within 2 to 3 days. So yellowing and as well as brown color spots can be seen. So coming to the management aspects, collect and destroy the infected veins and leaves, and soak the seed veins up with streptocycline 500 ppm and then Bodomixture 0.5% solution for 30 minutes can give relief, and along with soil drenching of 0.5% Bodomixture and application of super phosphate at the rate of 1500 kg per acre can reduce the incidence of the disease. And growing some resistant varieties like Karpaka and Pachahai Kodi are the resistant varieties are available. So coming to the second disease, Sclerotium foot rot or wilt, which is caused by Sclerotium rolfsi. So if you see the symptoms, we can see whitish cottony growth can be seen on the stem regions. So whitish cottony growth can be seen on stem as well as the roots also. So on later stages, leaves will droop, and drooping of leaves can be seen along with the later stages dry up, and it also produce a brown color or black color sclerotia on the infected stems and as well as infected lower stem regions or root regions. So coming to the management aspects, removing and destroying of infected plants, especially roots, and along with application of soil organic amendments like neem cake or green manure, and soil drenching with 0.1% carbendazim can also give relief. And the third one is powdery mildew, which is caused by Oidium piperis. We can see white color mycelial or powdery mycelial growth can be seen on the lower surface as well as the upper surface. On the both surfaces of leaf, we can clearly see the white color mycelial growth. The later stages, the leaves are converted into yellow in color and defoliation of leaves will occur. So coming to the management aspects, collect and destroy the infected leaves and vines, and along with the spraying of 0.2% wettable sulfur and dust spraying at the rate of 25 kilograms per hectare can control the pluckering of leaves. So the fourth one is anthraquinosis, which is caused by Coltotrichum piperis. On the right side, we can see initially small black color or brown color lesions. Initially small black color or brown color lesions can be seen as like of here. And initially small brown color black color lesions initially appears. So later the small spots enlarges in size and forms a concentric rings. Concentric rings, big rings can be clearly seen, which is covered with a yellow halo. Whatever the infected surface we can see with a yellow halo here. So and finally the spots are may develop onto the stems and griddle, and which are resulting in the weathering of leaves in later stages. So coming to the management aspects, collect and destroy the infected leaves and veins, and spraying of 0.2% xerum or 0.5% of Bodomixture can control the pluckering of leaves and as well as the disease. So coming to the bacterial spot or stem rot, which is caused by Xanthomonas campestris, Pathova, Belticola. So initially here brown water soaked spots or small spots can be happen that was surrounded by yellow halo. We can see here small brown water soaked spots initially appears that was surrounded by a yellow halo. We can clearly see all the small brown water soaked lesions that was covered by the yellow halo. In later stages, what will happen, lowering of internodes and small internodes also can be observed, along with stems will stems slowly starts to breaking, and griddling of vines can be seen. And later stages, the drying of leaves and stems can be clearly observed, especially the vines. So coming to the management aspects, collect and destroy the infected leaves and vines, and along with regular irrigation during cold weather seasons and spraying of streptocycline at the rate of 400 ppm plus Bodomistol combination 0.25% can at pluckering stage can control the disease. So coming to questions related to ARS, we can expect causal organisms from this betel vine. So this is about betel vine.